We will have the best spring break ever.
Just a perfect day. Drink sangria in the park. And then later, when it gets dark, we go home. Just a perfect day. Feed animals in the zoo. And then home. Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. Happy Stranger Things Day, my stranger friends. It is November 6th, 2021. It still is. Maybe by the time you hear this, it's November 7th. But for me, it is still November 6th. It is still Stranger Things Day 2021. Very excited to come back and talk to you guys already, since just putting out another entry to the book club. And it looks like we're going to be having a lot of book club entries before we get back to the season proper, the show proper. We got some information. We got some more video. We didn't get everything we were hoping for, but let's be realistic. They want to tease this out, and they're doing a pretty great job at that. What did we get? So we got the fourth video that we're going to listen to, because this is an audio, and then I'm going to go in depth listening to it, talking about everything I see. We got a season. We didn't get a date per se, but we got a season, summer 2022. Now, I saw a tweet that someone said, expect it to be July 1st, 2022, and they're going to announce it on Thanksgiving, I think, is what I thought I read that somewhere. So maybe Thanksgiving is when we get the proper trailer, which means I'm going to be like, hello, family. It's great to talk to you. I need to go record now. So can you put my turkey in the microwave so I can get back to what's important with life? I mean, I love seeing you all. Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. It's great to see you, but I see you guys way too much. I'm going to go watch the Stranger Things trailer again and again and again and put another episode up. But that's wishful thinking. That is someone tweeting it, so I have no idea if it's correct or not. So let's not deal with hypotheticals. Let's deal with what we know so far. We know, again, summer 2022. So, oh my goodness, we still have to get through winter and spring. Oh, those damn seasons. What else do we know? We know the episode titles. I love this because it really leads to so much speculation, because sometimes you're like, what does that mean? And sometimes you're like, oh, that has to mean this. So 8 titles. Shall we go through them all? Oh, yes, we shall. Chapter 1, The Hellfire Club. We knew this already. And we've seen a shirt that Dustin wears, the Hellfire Club. So, and I talked about that, I think, because we did talk about knowing some of the episode, or just this episode title. I don't think I know any other episode titles, but the Hellfire Club. So that one I've discussed in the past, and I don't remember what I said, so I can't remember. But it has something to do with Dustin, and it's an actual club that they're in. Number two, Vecna's Curse. Now you're going to say, well, who is Vecna? And I'm going to say, oh, not who is Vecna, what is Vecna? Because I just looked it up, and Vecna is a fictional character appearing in the Dungeons and Dragons fantasy role-playing game. Vecna has been named as one of the greatest villains in Dungeons and Dragons. So it's a Dungeons and Dragons connection. You know, they named the first, we had the Demogorgon, we've had the Mind Flayer, so now we have Vecna. So something is going to be is going to happen that's going to relate to whatever this monster is. It has now, and I read something about the curse. There was another link. I don't know if I can find that. But let's see, Vecna. I'm going to read just the quick description on him. Originally from the World of Greyhawk campaign setting, Vecna was described as a powerful wizard who became a leech. Which elite, L-I-C-H, leech is an undead creature. Oh my goodness. He was eventually destroyed, and his left hand and left eye were the only parts of his body to survive, even after he achieved godhood. Being a member of the third edition default pantheon of D&D gods, he is still described as missing both his left eye and hand. Vecna's holy symbol is an eye in the palm of a left hand. Vecna's right-hand man, and then ultimately his betrayer, is Kass the Bloody Hunter, a vampire whose sword, the Sword of Kass, is also an artifact. Oh my goodness, there is a lot going on with whatever the heck Vecna is. And there's this is a D&D, some kind of role-playing game message board that said, how and why does Vecna's curse transform wizards into Nothics? Rather than blah, 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 is there any further detail elsewhere? It says, rather than gaining the godlike supremacy they crave, some wizards who devote their lives to unearthing arcane secrets are reduced to creeping, tormented monsters by a dark curse left behind by Vecna, a powerful leech. Is it leech or licht? Lich, I don't know. But, okay, that's a lot more than I was expecting to get out of it. I thought Vecna was going to be a character in the show. Pretty cool, right? So it's some sort of monster, I'm guessing. Speaking of monster, the episode 3 title is The Monster and the Superhero. Now, I know someone who calls himself a superhero in Stranger Things. Bob Newby. But didn't Will also draw a picture of himself as a superhero? Or is he, no, Will just does the wizards and Bob Newby's the superhero. Could this be, could the monster in, okay, I'm just going to say this. We saw a picture of Will. We saw a video of Will in the trailer. I haven't got there yet. He's painting something. We'll talk more about that. But maybe the painting is called The Monster and the Superhero. It's just me guessing. Just me guessing, throwing it out there. Chapter 4, Dear Billy. Dear Billy, ooh, I am for real. That I don't know why. I started singing an Outkast song. We know this has to be a Max Heavy, a Max to the Max episode. I mean, Billy was a dick, let's be honest. Then it was kind of tragic. His dickness was tragic because he was taken over. He was, you know, when he was purely like evil, it wasn't Billy. It was the Mind Flayer. And then at the end, he kind of died a hero. A very tragic tale of a boy who just grew up terribly and, you know, basically took it out on the world. And then at the end, he died kind of being heroic. So I wonder if this is like Max's kind of being cathartic, kind of just looking at things, saying, you know, dear Billy, and having to deal with it. I wonder. Chapter 5, The Nina Project. Yeah, I got nothing with this one. Nina, there doesn't seem to be a Nina character yet on the show. So I don't know what to think there. So The Nina Project. Maybe it's like The Mindy Project. Nina. I mean, maybe it's a character. I'm going to guess. There is a character named Nina. And, or could Nina be someone back in the Hawkins lab in the past? Because we do. I don't know. I was going to say I'm going there because we do know that part of season four has flashbacks, right? Because we see younger Eleven and we hear the voice of Dr. Brenner. I wonder if the Nina Project has anything to do with that. I'm going to say no, just because of the other two titles that we see that come in 7 and 8. That is The Massacre at Hawkins Lab and Papa. Now, The Massacre at Hawkins Lab, I feel like Hawkins Lab is done. So maybe this is the one where we go back and we kind of see something bad happen. But then again, the next episode's called Papa. So maybe this is when we go back, or maybe Brenner is back. Ugh. Oh my goodness. It's crazy. But you know what I like? I like that we have 9 episodes again in this season, which tells me that one of these episodes is a flashback episode. That is, you know, like, even though it wasn't a flashback episode, we had that kind of standalone episode where Eleven was bitching and, you know, she hung out with her sister and all those guys. It was kind of her, I don't want to say a spinoff, but it was kind of her, like, learning more about herself. And then we came back and it was, you know, let's go crazy for the big finale. And I feel like this could be that again, where 8 is the Papa episode, where we see, you know, something, you know, in the past. And then it ends with, we're back in the present, let's go crazy. And that's when we get to chapter 9, The Piggyback, which... I mean, the piggyback. I don't know. It's not the piggy bank. It's the piggyback. Now, when you piggyback on something, you jump on their back to kind of join forces, right? Maybe it's sometimes you think you do a piggyback ride to help the person on your back that they can't walk. You're kind of aiding them. But there's also that idea that, you know, you're piggybacking on them. They're helping you. You're joined together and you're off to fight Vecna? I don't know. I'm just guessing. Is Vecna the California California Demogorgon? It's like, hey, what's up, man? I'm Vecna. I'm gonna steal you. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna steal Eleven's powers, man. That's my impersonation of a California demon. I think I nailed it. So those are the 9 episodes. The 9 chapters in Stranger Things 4. I mean, how? Now we have to wait. I mean, I know it's November, and December's right around the corner, and 2022 is right around the corner. But, you know, I had this feeling, this hunch, that when they said 2022, they literally meant right at the beginning of 2022. Surprise, here's your new season. But, no. They want to really stretch this out and really make us wait. And it's like, I want it now, Daddy. I'm not actually asking my dad that. That's from Willy Wonka. Come on, guys. You know that. But besides the episode titles and besides the fact that we know it's now going to be summer 2022, they did some other cool things. I'm not going to play them all here. They did Mr. Clark, the actor, plays Mr. Clark, was hanging out in one of the pop-up stores. It looked like a lot of cool things. There's one in, I think it's in San Francisco, and or was it Los Angeles? And one in New York. And I'm not near either of those, so there's no pop-up store for me. So if you were able to get to one of the pop-up stores, let me know if how cool it was. You can you can always email me, strangerdanger@fansnotexperts.com. Another thing they did, which was kind of cool, were these little mixtapes, they called them. They put one out for each of the seasons, season one, season two, season three. And it's just little clips of fun. It's not even, it wasn't even like narrative driven. It was just fun little clips of quotable moments, you know, mornings are for coffee and contemplation, that kind of stuff, going all the way back to season one. But then the most exciting thing we got, remember we had 1 of 4, 2 of 4, 3 of 4. And finally today we got 4 of 4, the fourth little teaser video. Welcome to California.
Dear Mike, today is day 185. I think I have finally adapted.
All right. Hold on to your butts, bro chachos.
I even like school now. I have made lots of friends. Even so, I am ready for spring break. Mostly because I get to see you. We will have the best spring break ever.
Okay, that was awesome. But now are you ready for a 13-minute version of this trailer where I stop at every 2 seconds to talk? I hope you are, because here we go.
Dear Mike, today is day 185.
All right, I'm already stopping it. This is going to take a while to get through, folks, so sit tight with me. First thing we see is this. Now, we know we're in California because that's the title of this video on YouTube. But we see this kind of wide shot of California, some suburban just grid of houses where everything just looks kind of meh, kind of like, I don't know if it's in the, I think we learn later it's in the spring. So the yards aren't very bright. Maybe there's a drought going on, and all the houses kind of look the same. And the first thing I notice is that 11 says it's day 185 now. I'm no mathematician, but hey, Google, what's 185 divided by 30?
185 divided by 30 is approximately 6.17.
Okay, so, you know, give or take a day here or there, we're talking about 6 months. It's been about 6 months since they've moved to California. And then we see this house, which looks pretty nice on the outside. It looks like a nicer house than what they had in Hawkins. But Joyce, we see Joyce's car still out front. The same old Joyce Byers car.
I think I have finally adapted.
Okay, now 11 says, I think I finally adapted. And we see her kind of making a diorama in an old Reebok box, which takes me back. And it's definitely, she's made a little hopper. She's made a little hopper, and he's hanging outside a little cabin, you know, the cabin they lived in. So, it's very cute and very kind of sad to see. So let's keep rolling. Oh, now we see our friend Will. Oh, it's a real quick shot of Will. He's hanging out in, I'm going to guess, in his bedroom. I was going to say an office area. But I see a bed in the lower left-hand corner. I see drawings on the back wall. So he looks like he's painting. He's at an easel. So he's staying artistic. And he's got a Cure poster on the wall. So he's very into his, like, very like dramatic, serious music. This is 1986, right? So I'm talking, I was 10 years old. I was very much like into Kiss at this point, and probably Poison right about now. But let's continue. So we see, oh, Jonathan, his hair is a little longer. He looks like he's high. Maybe he's getting high all the time, but he looks like he's a smoking what they call a bit of the doobie. And up pulls a Surfer Boy pizza.
Hold on to your butts, bro, chachos.
Inside the van gets Will and 11, maybe, and probably Jonathan. Or actually, is Jonathan going to school? Is he a senior yet? I forget. But Will and 11 are getting into this car. So this, I'm guessing, is their ride to work. And she looks like she's holding the Reebok box. So that diorama looks like it's going to be some sort of school project. And this is when we meet our first new character. Hold on to your butts, brochachos. That is, I know that's one of the characters that we talked about. He's the pizza delivery boy. And I'm guessing he's one of Will's friends, who is just very California dude, you know, cowabunga, I'm a ninja turtle. And he looks like he will be a lot of fun on this show.
I even like school now.
Ooh, well, 11 says she even likes school now. And we see a sign, countdown to spring break only. Was it one more day, I think they're saying, is when this kid takes the sign down. So getting excited, spring break's coming for 11. And Will?
I have made lots of friends.
She said, I've made lots of friends. And she does wave at a kid and smile. And it looks like, at first I thought the kid ignored her, but the girl does smile back. And then 11 gives a look like, oh my goodness. First I thought it was because she ignored her. But now I'm thinking she gave a look that like, wow, this girl actually smiled at me. Also, 11's hair's longer. And she's got bangs, and she very much reminds me of Joyce. She has like Joyce's hair. So I don't know if that's just the style, or if she just Joyce is like, yeah, get your hair cut like mine. Come on, let's go.
Even so, I am ready for spring break. Mostly
okay.
Because I get to see you.
Now we see two California jerks. One of the kids got a straw. He did a you know, what are those called? Oh my god, a spitball. I can't believe I didn't remember. But these kids look like jerks that 11 has to deal with. But she sent this letter to Mike, and she's all excited. She gets to see him again, and now we see young Mike, looking not so young anymore, reading the letter, hanging out in his bedroom, all happy to finally hear from 11.
We will have the best spring break ever.
And then here's where things go crazy. All right, let's go through everything. We see 11 not looking so great on a bus, I'm guessing. Then we see the Rink-O-Mania. Roller rinks were all the rage. I don't know if there's anyone that I recognize doing these roller skating moves. But my goodness gracious, we used to have, I don't know, do they do anything like this anymore? When I was a kid, you'd go to birthday parties, at the roller rink. We had a place called Roll On America here, up in my neighborhood. We'd have Halloween, the school Halloween parties at the roller rink. And I once wore my werewolf mask there. Again, I think Kiss was playing, and I was really, really, well, I thought I looked good. Let's be honest. I didn't fall, so that's good. Then we cut to, looks like Joyce opening a box and seeing a very creepy doll. I don't know what's going on with that thing. Trying to see if there's any connection. It just looks like a very creepy, strange doll. And she looks really confused looking at it, wondering what the heck it is. Then we see, okay, this is where a little craziness goes on. There's gunshots. Are we in Mike's house? Is this back in the Wheeler house? I can't tell. But I see a gun shot. Then I see what appears to be, it looks like we're in Will's room, but that this looks like Mike. I'm pretty sure based on the coat that I saw in another video and the hair, this looks like Mike at Will's house. So maybe they go to California. Mike goes to California instead of 11 coming back to Hawkins. Jonathan is freaking out about something, and there's someone outside smashing through the window. I don't know who, what it is. I'm trying to get a glimpse of it. I'm slowing it down. Zoom and enhance. There's definitely someone back there. I don't know if it's a monster or a person. They're holding something, looks like over their head, and smashing it through. I'm going to try to watch it again. I don't know what it is. Then we see a shot of our friend Murray Ballman. He's got headphones on and he looks a little in shock, a little like, what's going on? Takes the headphones off. We see some sort of police chase. I see a van and two cars. I'm going to guess this is where we see, remember in the one of the previous videos, we saw Eleven being taken by these two guys in suits. But it says prisoner transport. So what is going on there? Keep back. I mean, that would be, Eleven can't be a prisoner, can she be? Oh my goodness, but it looks like these cars that look like police cars from the 80s, like undercover police cars, but I don't see any sirens on them or any lights or anything indicating they're police officers. They look like they're trying to pull over this van. We see a high heel coming out of one car. Don't know if that's one of these cars. It looks like it might be based on the fact that it's the desert in the background. So maybe these two cars pull over the van and a woman gets out. That's a guess. Back to skating, someone skating. It looks like we see roller skates. We see high socks. We see dark skin. So it's an African-American. So it could be Erica. It could be Lucas. Could be someone else. We don't know. I hope to hell it's Lucas, and I hope he loves roller skating, and I hope he's really good at it. Now we see a door, a strange door that is in the middle of nowhere. This door looks just like, I don't even know how to explain it, but obviously, my guess is that there are steps that go down, and I don't know what the hell, what that is all about, but there's a keypad on it, so there must be some sort of California base. It's got to be related, right? It has to be. We see an overhead shot of people standing by something. Now, could it be that the same door that we saw? We see four looking Jeeps that look kind of military. Don't know. It's a great shot, but I don't know what it's leading to. I'm just going through every little glimpse we see. That Surfer Boy pizza van now looks like it's been run off the road. And it looks like I see Mike in the van with Will in the van. They look a little freaked out. So I hope, hopefully the van is their means of transport. Now we see, I don't know what's going on here, the County Line Cafe. You're going to start seeing shirts probably for that. There are two cars. Maybe these are the same cars we saw pull over the van. Two men in suits. We just see the back of them just really quick. We see that. We see the same shot of Eleven with those two men that we saw in a previous video. It looks like it's that van. And it looks like these guys are the County Line Cafe. So now I'm just going to make a wild guess that these guys break Eleven out of whatever she's in the van, hand her over to the woman who gets out of the car. And then these guys are standing guard outside the Country Line Cafe as Eleven is meeting with this person inside the cafe, which isn't really a cafe. These are all guesses. These are just guesses. I'm based on watching this a few times. We see definitely some sort of underground laboratory looking thing. Is that a couple guys in a gas mask? Oh, they're shooting. And it looks like there's army men shooting maybe back at them. Now we see more men shooting. That's not Hopper, is it? I see Will. I see Mike. I see Jonathan. This is all going on. And this is definitely the new buyer's house. More shooting. a nice stereo, turning the volume up. That's kind of signifying that, hey, we are turning the volume up on this season. Oh my goodness, now we see those same four Jeeps that we saw before being, looks like they're being chased by the helicopter. And then a giant, and I mean giant, explosion. And I think it's one of those Jeeps. Now, who is this person? Who is that 11? Because I'm looking at the jacket and the arms. I'm going to rewind back to when we saw 11 get pulled over by these guys. And she's in a plaid shirt. So the person who's seeing the explosion, I can't tell. But the hair looks shorter, so I don't know what's going on there. I wonder if that's 11 seeing the explosion. No, it isn't. I don't think so. Oh my goodness, how exciting is this? And then, of course, we see Stranger Things 4. So there it is, my sort of in-depth look at the trailer there. At one point, I was trying to pause it and line up the video, the audio of the trailer and me. And then at some point, I was just like, let me just talk through this and just kind of show everything that we're looking at. So what did we see there? I mean, we saw, it looks like Mike is out in California with Will and 11 and Jonathan and Joyce. So Mike went out there for spring break. We don't see Lucas. We don't see Dustin. Now, remember, we see them back at the Creel house in a previous video. Mike wasn't there, right? That's because Mike is in California. Right? I'm not mistaking this, right? So is this kind of the two groups? You know how I am, folks. I'm not happy until our entire group's meet up and they're together. I love it when two groups who are, you know, trying to get to some ultimate goal finally meet up. I love it. And it looks like we're going to have to do that again this year. I hope we'll be doing that again. Because we don't see that side all, right? We don't see anybody, Lucas, Dustin, Max, Robin, Steve, or Nancy. Look at that. I'm good with the names, right? Boom, right off the top of my head. Whew. Phew. I gotta, you know, keep up the appearance that I know what I'm talking about here. So, a lot of excitement. A lot of intrigue. What are these explosions? What is this door? Is there some sort of secret base? Probably. What are they running from? Who are they running from? Who's this foot that gets out of the car? This foot that has a heel, a sensible pump. Is that the same thing as a heel? I don't know. What is this? What are we going to find out? It's exciting, isn't it? But that's really all we have. That's really all we have to go on. And now it's just more the waiting game. Waiting for an actual date. Waiting for an actual trailer. Hopefully that thing I saw online about Thanksgiving is correct and we get a full trailer. Hopefully July 1st is correct and we don't have to wait much further into the summer. And I think that's it. I think I covered just about everything that I meant to cover. If I left anything out, you know where to find me. Again, StrangerDanger@fansnotexperts.com. StrangerDPod on Twitter. And you can always leave a voicemail message or write a review on iTunes. Those are really cool and hip too. Even if you don't use iTunes. I wish there was a way for you guys to write reviews on Spotify. Because from what I understand, most of you people listen on Spotify. Hello, Spotify people. But again, thank you to you Apple people and Google people and Amazon people and whatever podcast app you use. I just appreciate so much that after all these years, you still listen to the podcast and we all still love Stranger Things. How could you not? Oh my goodness. So I want to thank you guys all for listening. Thank you all for subscribing. And until we get some news, or until we have another book club meeting, because I'm sure we'll be having one of those pretty soon, or I shouldn't say that, pretty soon. We'll be having one of those soon enough. But until then, my friends, I want you to stay strange and beware Vecna's curse.
Just watch your soul. Fat Not Experts.